To use Microsoft's Maps feature, the first thing you'll want to do is open a browser and go to www.bing.com. Once you're on the Bing homepage, click on the Maps tool that's in the upper left. When you hover over it, or when you first click, you'll get a drop-down list, but go ahead and just click on the link. When you open the Maps page, the first thing that you'll see is a symbolic map right here. The two tools that you'll want to use in the map area, and this is the map area, are the road and bird's eye tools. For right now, for the purposes of this tutorial, ignore these links right over here on the right-hand side. In addition to using the road and the bird's eye, it might be helpful to look at the map in full screen. Once you are familiar with these basic tools, it's relatively easy to zoom in on a location that is specific to where you are located. So, for instance, I am located in Charlottesville, Virginia. So to drill down to Charlottesville, Virginia, I can double click, or I can use the plus and minus tools right over here in the right hand area of the screen. So as I drill down to Virginia and Charlottesville, I'm just double clicking. I can also use the plus tool. And I'm going to zoom into the Curry School of Education. So once you're zoomed in, you can switch between this more symbolic version of a map to the bird's eye, which will provide a pictorial representation of where you are located. So for instance, right here, you can see Bavaro Hall. And you can see Ruffner Hall, and these are two locations on the Curry campus. If this was being done with primary school children, you would want to zoom in and show the pictorial representation first of the location where they are at, and then using the different views, bird's eye or road, switch between the map and the bird's eye view, zooming out to provide additional perspective of what maps actually tell people when they are looking at them.